Chapter 26, Problem Number 4. The frequency of a light wave is the same when the light travels in ethyl alcohol or in carbon disulfide. Find the ratio of the wavelength of the light in ethyl alcohol to that in carbon disulfide. So for this problem, we are going to use two different equations. The first equation is this right here. The index of refraction is equal to the speed of light over the speed of light in the material. And this is the speed of light in the vacuum. And then the second equation that we're going to use, which will come in a little later, is this equation right here, which can be found in chapter 16. And this is the the velocity of light in the material is equal to the frequency times the wavelength. And so you may have to look up these values, but the index of refraction for alcohol, or N1, is going to be 1.362, and N2, or the index of refraction for disulfide, is equal to 1.632. And so we're basically going to start off by just writing two different equations using this mother equation right here. So we know that N1 is equal to C over V1, and I'm going to write another equation where N2 is equal to C over V2. The C's right here is always going to be equal to the speed of light, which is just 3.0 times 10 to the 8th meters per second. And once we do this and we know that these two C's from these equations are the same, we can set these two equations equal to one another if we get C on the same side. So I'm just going to do a little algebra real quick. And so we know that we can set these two equations equal to one another. And what I'm going to do is divide both sides by V2 and divide by both sides by N1. So I'm going to get V1 over V2 is equal to N2 over N1. And basically, I wrote the equation like this because I'm going to now start working with this equation right here, because a part of the problem states that the frequency of a light wave is the same when the light travels in ethyl alcohol or in carbon dioxide. So it's saying that the frequency is the same for the disulfide and the alcohol. And so using this equation right here that I wrote down earlier, I'm going to do the same thing that I did before with this equation and make two different equations. And so V1 is equal to, I guess I'll put F1 for now, times lambda 1. And then my second equation will be this right here. Like I just said, the problem states that the frequency of light is the same when it travels through the alcohol and the disulfide, meaning that F1 is equal to F2. And so I'm going to rewrite these two equations right here. And I'm going to do so by dividing this by lambda 1, and then I'll do the same over here, except I'll divide by lambda 2. We can set these two equations equal to one another because we know that the frequencies are the same. And once we do that, we can simply rewrite the equation right here. Excuse me, this should be V2, lambda 2, this should be the V1 right here. V1 right here over lambda 1 is equal to V2 over lambda 2. And in order to figure out the ratio of the wavelength of the light in ethyl alcohol to that in carbon disulfide, I am going to basically set this equation to make it look similar to this one, meaning I'm going to rewrite this equation as such so that I have V1 over V2, just like I have in this equation right here, so that I can set these two equations equal to one another. So I'm going to rewrite both equations over here so that it'll be a little easier to see. And again, I'm just rewriting equations. And so now that you can see that, I'm going to set these two equal to one another. And now what we have here is what the problem is asking for. It is asking for find the ratio of the wavelength of light in ethyl alcohol to that in carbon disulfide, which is exactly what we have here. This is the lambda for ethyl alcohol, and this is the lambda for carbon disulfide. And so we have the values for N2 and N1, and from here all we have to do is plug in and once you plug that in, you should get a value equal to 1.198. There are no units because this is a ratio.